When you walk through the woods here in the Northwest, it's not the new that gives you pause or that makes you stop and take notice. It's the old, like the 150-year-old Douglas fir trees, great spires to the sky. Or the logs that are down throughout the forest. They've been down for generations, many of them, now given their life to be the home for every variety of lichen and moss and exquisite, exotic-looking ferns. The log itself is a great metaphor for nurturing. When I look at this log, I think of two things. One is that nurturing is about particularity, which really means that it's about a commitment to this time, this space, these elements, these plants. Come hell or high water, you risk and you try and you give and you birth and you lose and you grieve and you nurture and you try again. This fern is called a licorice fern. It's fragile. We didn't plant it here. No human could. It owes its existence to this log. The licorice fern grows out of old logs, old stumps. It reminds me of a great story about two parents who had a daughter. They wanted to go visit an art gallery, and of course their daughter didn't want to go. Who can blame her? She was about six. But the parents did what they do with kids. You make them go and tell them to have a good time. Well, it was a large art gallery with many exhibits. In the first room, there were many pieces of small blown glass, exquisite, expensive looking. The next room, oil painting. And the next, watercolor. And the next, sculptor. And the next, pen and ink. And on and on. The little girl did make it through the evening, and the parents were relieved. After the show was over, they asked her, "Well, honey, was it okay?" "Yes," she said, "it was okay. But mostly what I wanted to do was touch the fragile things. Mostly what I want to do is touch the fragile things. And now I know why. Because the fragile things only exist when someone has given their life to nurture them. This space, this time, this place, where you risk and you give, and you try, and you hope, and you dream, and you lose, and then you nurture, and you try again."